dropped a little bit of weight my sophomore year in high school. It was the first time I had a boyfriend, and I got those comments that, oh, you look so good, and so that, you know, fuels the eating disorder. And, you know, no one knew that I was, you know, either starving myself during the day, and then if I would eat, I would throw up. You know, was listening to all the, you know, all the voices in my head that were saying, you're fat, you're ugly, this will make you feel better. And for the moment, at times, like, purging did make me feel better, or starving myself did make me feel better. I felt this sense of control, I felt power, I felt better than you because you were eating and I wasn't. I was doing things that were really shameful that I could not tell anybody, and I was never honest with anybody about any of that stuff. So anything else I was ever feeling, I kind of bottled up and just pushed it down and didn't really do much with it. And I got it out by purging, which was basically like purging my anger. Or I would eat because my parents asked me to or told me to, and then, you know, kind of get back at them. I would hurt myself and I would purge, or it was just a compulsion. Like, I had to do it. There was no, in my head, there was no rhyme or reason, or there was really no choice. I felt so alone. I felt as if I was the only one going through what I was going through. I felt like I was the only one who couldn't eat a meal. I mean, who can't feed themselves? And that's how I felt. I mean, that is truly what I thought. I was like, you are, I thought I was pathetic. It's all a matter of picking up the phone, because that's the only thing you really have to do. Because from that point on, you have a built-in support network and you have people that will help take care of you and teach you how to take care of yourself. Heroes are made when you make a choice.